Did you know that you can record your presentations in PowerPoint with video or just audio? And if you're an advanced PowerPoint user, there's a good chance that you can make your own videos look very professional. In fact, I'm using PowerPoint right now, and we'll do that for the entire video and use it to record everything that you see on screen. So, why would you use PowerPoint to create videos? Well, you just might want to record yourself with audio presenting slides that you've already prepared. And of course, you can add video like you're seeing here. And by the way, this also works in real time if you're presenting PowerPoint over Teams or Zoom using a capability called Cameo, which puts your camera feed right inside your PowerPoint, and it can be full screen like this, or you can use any other shape that works in PowerPoint, like this small circle. And notice the subtle reflection too and soft edges. It's just like any other object in PowerPoint. Or you can choose to not record the video feed on each slide and just record your own audio like you're seeing here. And I've used quite a few different editing tools and suites, and the amount of controls can be pretty daunting. So PowerPoint's just a lot simpler, and I would argue even with video editors out there, a few things are a lot easier. Like for example, text on the screen like you're seeing here. You also have a lot of different text effects that you can use with it being PowerPoint, effectively like a text editor. And you can use your existing PowerPoint presentations pretty easily. And you can easily use the transitions and animations that you already know and love. So, like this transition here. And the good news is there are no complicated timelines or layers to deal with here either. And there are a couple different bonus capabilities as you can record your own videos in PowerPoints as videos, so each slide will get its own video. You can re-record one slide at a time, and you can continue to edit the slides before you import the videos. And if you're like me and have trouble remembering what to say, there's even a teleprompter built in using your PowerPoint notes. All right, so let me show you then how to do this using PowerPoint so we can put together a recording of the PowerPoint slides and see the slides I was just using for that intro. Okay, so to record PowerPoint from another PowerPoint, what I'm going to actually do here is go to the Record tab. And this is kind of where we're going to spend most of our time anyway, as we show Cameo and some of the features inside of PowerPoint, the first one that I recorded those different clips from. So I'm going to record my screen. Now, the way to do that is to use screen recording built into PowerPoint. And that's going to pop up a little modal up here that says first, I can choose audio pointer and select the area that I want. So I'm going to go ahead and do that and select the area. One thing to note here, when you do record kind of PowerPoint inside of PowerPoint, or you have a couple different recording layers going, they're using more or less the same internals. So you can't record yourself, let's say, with a snipping tool and see this little guy and then start recording the other PowerPoint. So I'm going to go ahead and hit record, and then we're going to move to a previous recording where I did record the other PowerPoint screen. And you'll see that it's going to do a countdown for me. And now I'm actually recording, and the modal kind of slides up to the top of the screen. Okay, so now when I record from PowerPoint 2, you can see that I've got PowerPoint 1 open. And the first thing is, because I've already recorded all the different video screens, I've got everything in here that you just saw in terms of the full end-to-end set of recording. So it was exactly what you just saw. Now here, to reset everything, I'm going to go ahead and do reset to Cameo, and I'm going to reset all the different slides. So for example, if you didn't have the Cameo recording layer on there, what you'd actually do is just add Cameo to it. So if I want to, I can add it to this slide, I can change the shape of the Cameo, and then I can make it so that it uses the entire frame of the video like I did before. And because it's like any other image, I can send it backwards or forwards. I can change the shape of it, etc., like you saw before. So I did that for each of these different slides here, and each of them has kind of animation. So you saw my lower third. You saw also here a lower third in terms of video creation. And you can see all the different notes that we're going to use in a second for the teleprompter. Now, of course, at any time, you can actually turn on the video and you can see and check your framing, make sure everything looks okay. Or you can stop it, so like I'm doing right here. And for like other videos that you don't want to show, where you don't want to show the actual video feed itself, and you just want to record the audio, you can put a Cameo outside of the view of the slide, effectively, like I'm doing here to the right. And that way, you just have the slide itself showing without any video. And, you know, just moving on to the rest of the slides, the nice thing is in here you can see there's a lot of different animations. So here I'm actually doing line by line and letter by letter. So it looks like the letters are being typed on the screen. Same thing for all of these different text-based slides. And also things like transitions work as well. So if I go here to the different transitions, you'll see that I've got the crush transition going from one slide to the next slide. Okay, so now that we have everything kind of set up and we can start, what we'll do is go to the recording tab. So I've got all my slides done with Cameo videos already imported in them. I can test it one more time to make sure everything is working, and I can see that my video is indeed working. So now from here, what I can do is record from the beginning. So here you can see that I have everything set up to record. So here, just to show some of the different capabilities and views. So right now, I've actually got the teleprompter turned on with automatic scrolling, so you can enable it or disable it. I've got my speed here, which is about in the middle. You can see that I've got my microphone already set up and it's not muted. And for camera, I can turn that on or off here, and I can actually select the different microphones or cameras that I want to use. And I've got a few different options for myself. Now, a couple other things that I can also see is I can decide to blur the background, which is pretty cool if I want to show blurred background, or I can actually show the background. So kind of like in Teams, you can actually blur the background out and here are the different views that you have. So right now I have teleprompter, which is up top. I can also do presenter view, which is kind of like the normal PowerPoint presenter view where the different things are to the side. So if I was looking over it, you can see that my eyes are to the side here. But if I go back to, I can go to slide view, but if I go back to teleprompter view, it means I can look at the top here like I'm doing right now because my camera is right on top of the monitor. So that makes it a lot easier to make more or less eye contact with the camera as you record. So in my case, I'm gonna actually just record one slide, but you'd go through all the different slides and I'll maybe go quickly through the other ones just to see what the process looks like so I can show you that. So did you know that you can record your presentations in PowerPoint with video or just audio? And if you're an advanced PowerPoint user, there's a good chance that you can make your videos look very professional. In fact, I'm using PowerPoint right now and we'll do that for the entire video and use it to record everything that you see on screen. So I just now hit the right arrow to advance my lower third, which actually had basically some timer built into it at 2.5 seconds, I think, to also minimize it. Now I'm going to advance the slide to the next one. In my case, I'm not going to actually use the teleprompter text to read from, but you can see just how easy it is to move between the different frames that you have. So here I've got the different frame now for the round camera. Then I have the different frame where I'm just showing how you can capture audio. And here I'm showing the different slide text that I'm showing basically being typed on. I can go through it a bit quicker and transition to my next slide. And you can see also that I've got that crush transition built in. So you can see it's very easy to do, just like making your own PowerPoint. And you can follow the text that's in the teleprompter if you want to, or like I'm doing right now, you can decide to go rogue and just advance the slides at your own pace with your own text if you want to do that too. Now, of course, you can set up the different scroll speeds like I showed before in terms of your reading speed. So now I'm going to go ahead and go to the very final slide, which is this one. Then I'm going to advance it, and that's going to stop the recording because this is the last slide in the presentation. Or I can manually stop it if I want to with the stop recording button. So here I'm just going to advance it. And now everything is stopped. Now, one thing to note here before I move on is that you do have the ability to, for example, use text markup and laser pointers and things like that on the PowerPoint, which I didn't show because I don't usually do that myself, but you have that ability just like you would have if you were doing an actual PowerPoint presentation. So now that I've kind of got everything recorded, I can decide to export straight away or I can go back and edit it. So in my case, I'm gonna go back and edit it. That takes me out of the presentation view of the screen. And you can see that for each of these different slides, I have my own small little video from the different recordings. Everything is saved, even the ones that are kind of just doing audio that are off to the right of the slide. Everything is kind of saved and ready to go in terms of the export. So now, if I want to do that, basically these are all each individual short videos, as you're seeing here. And I can export this to a video, and that's going to take a few minutes. So I'm going to go ahead and quickly just hit export to video, but we're not going to see the entire export because it does take some time to export the video. So from here, you can decide to save it in your OneDrive location, or you can decide to put it locally on your desktop. So I'm going to go ahead and just use the normal PowerPoint title in my case and hit export. And here I'm exporting at 1080p, but you can also select 4K and 720p and other resolutions as well. So 1080p is usually a great choice in terms of the resolution to output. I'm not going to wait for the entire thing to render complete end to end. So I'm gonna stop talking right now and we'll come back in a sec. That took about 5 or so minutes to render. Let's test it out.
So did you know that you can record your presentations in PowerPoint with video or just audio?
Okay, so this time I'm actually going to record from PowerPoint 1 that had all of my other videos in it, and I'm going to record my screen and show you where that actually saved to. So in my case, I put it in the downloads folder, as you can see here, and that's the video that we just recorded that had all the detail in it. So it's going to save wherever you direct it to save to. Now I'll go ahead and add another slide so that we can actually get me back on the screen here for you. I'm just going to go ahead and insert, I'm going to go ahead and go to the record and insert a cameo on it and then extend it over here. So you saw how just in a few minutes I was able to basically get a PowerPoint set up. I put in all the different cameo videos effectively across the different PowerPoint slides. And then I use normal transitions, text treatment, all the things that you normally do in PowerPoint to create a full video, then record it with the teleprompter and render it all in just a couple of minutes. Again, these are all things that would take hours to do with a video editor, and you can do it all in PowerPoint relatively easily. Yes, it doesn't have quite as many features, and no, I don't expect video editors to start jumping away from things like DaVinci Resolve or other things into PowerPoint. But if you don't have any editing software and you're not comfortable, I guess, using a timeline, doing all the stuff that you'd normally have to do in a video editor, PowerPoint is a good substitute for something like that in a pinch. And it lets you do some pretty cool things in terms of all the different visual effects you can add to your different PowerPoint slides. So hopefully this video helped. If it did, give me a like. Otherwise, subscribe to my channel for other tips like this. And thank you so much for watching.